Nova Cinema. I've been doing this show for, not that long, but, you know, I think it's time for Best Sub, because the well is kind of one dry. I joke, of course. I have many, many ideas, just a bit too lazy to film them. Anyways, I have handpicked all of these shorts as my favorites from the entire series, and let's start out with a bang with one of my favorite shorts of all time. It's The List, and I can't really say much without giving anything away, so take a look.
The schedule, okay? Okay, sick and tired of these damn hoes telling me when our appointments are. I'm the doctor and I should know when they are.
No, I can't go tomorrow. I have to work. Yeah, I know. It sucks. What are you going to do? I know, right? Fuck! Oh, my God!
Hi.
Who are you?
17 years ago, your mom was pregnant. And at the 6 month of pregnancy, she realized she didn't want the baby no more. She couldn't handle it. So she went to the only doctor she could find who would abort a baby at 6 months. After the surgery, they threw me in the dumpster behind the abortion clinic. They thought I was dead, but I wasn't. They only stopped me from growing.
That's not possible.
I killed the doctor and your mother. And now I'm going to kill you. Because she kept you only 3 years after she got rid of me. What's so special about you? Nothing.
Oh! Yeah. Ugh!
Bye-bye, little bro.
No!
Wow, it's kind of a shocking ending. I've seen it many times and it still surprises me. No, actually it doesn't. I'm lying. But next short is a fan favorite. I most people that have seen it have really enjoyed it. I don't, but I know most people do, and this is called Fish in a Barrel. It's about a bunch of guys who go on a fishing trip and, well, they start to get killed off one by one. It's the closest I've ever come to a slasher film, and enjoy.
Oh, you guys are going fishing again, huh?
Yeah, you know we go up to Mr. Reed's Lake every other weekend.
Well, that sounds like fun.
Always is.
Yeah, I've never been fishing before.
You know what?
What?
I think we need more sandwiches.
All right, boys, you ready?
Heck yeah, let's go fishing.
Let's do it.
Man, I can't wait to go fishing. I hear they got bass as big as my arms this time of year.
Your ass is as big as my arm. You want a beer, faggot?
Yeah, give me one.
Yeah, I'll have one too.
I think you're ready. Do you want one?
Really? No fooling?
Historical moment, boys. Junior's first beer.
I remember my first beer. I remember not being a pansy when I drank it. Man, this is really nice.
Sure is.
Hey Vince, you finally gonna catch something today? You better, he's not getting no dinner. Man, I gotta take a leak.
Yeah, me too.
Was this some kind of secret love affair, boys?
Like Brokeback Mountain or something?
Alright Vince, you take your leak over here. I'm gonna go over there. I don't feel like playing swords, alright?
I wasn't planning on it.
Man, you gotta lighten up, you have a sense of humor.
Whatever.
What the hell are you doing here?
Where's your lover?
What?
Where's Joe?
I don't know. I went to get some bait shop and I saw the guy here before me.
Where's the bait?
They ran out.
They ran out of bait at a bait shop.
Yeah, I never saw anything like it before.
You guys can... You got a bite?
I think I got some.
Bring it in. Reel it in.
I don't know.
Come on, two hands. What are you doing? What the hell is this? Get to see that. You don't know what you're doing!
Why'd you get break the pole?
God!
I work 60 hours a week for your ass!
See, I told you you shouldn't bring him on these fishing trips. I'll go after him.
What's your problem, man?
You guys are speaking
to future. I want to take my son out to a nice day of fishing, and I got to deal with these freaking shenanigans, the little freaking prima donna, as usual.
You guys don't have to mess with me all the time.
You can't take a freaking joke. Clark was right. I never should have brought you. What, little pains? You gonna cry now? Vince? Samantha?
You should have taken me fishing. The only reason I married you is because I knew you went fishing every weekend. Not one time in 5 years did you take me fishing. Not once!
You're freaking crazy!
Ah!
trendy one on here, two surprising endings in a row. Let's hope it keeps going like that. I like those kinds of things. And that Shyamalan-esque. But our next one is from our Christmas special, and I know what you might be thinking. A Christmas special and the best of it. It's not Christmas. I can't be watching this. This is outrageous. But no, you're wrong for thinking that. Because it's amazing, and it's one of my greatest performances as a stumbling drunk. And also, it's not too Christmassy, the beginning and ending, but if you cut those out, it would just seem like a regular horror film cinema short, so enjoy The Gift.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Any donation would do! Help a needy child with a donation! Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Hello, young man.
Yes, yeah, guys.
Hello. Donation, please?
Oh, yeah. I got this. I got a very good donation for you. See my back.
Happy Merry Christmas.
All right, come on. Just get out of here, man. Try to do something nice here for the kids.
You should see.
All right, just get lost, okay? I'm trying to do something for, you know, charity.
You can call the cops. You can call the cops. You're a forger. He's a forger. With your beard, Santa. You're pretending to be Santa Claus. All these nice people. You're forgering them. Okay.
Get out of here.
Hey. Hey. Santa's tough now. Santa's tough. Hey.
Yo, I'm gonna kick your fucking ass and fuck out of here.
Oh, yeah, right? Santa. You get to the captain. May he rest in his watery grave, huh? See you later, tough guy.
You know what? I'm calling the cops.
See you later, Saint Dick. Hey!
Right there.
Forgot about you, present. My part. One of my parts, I got a CD player, y'all need it.
Richie.
If you're not present, you're a demon. I don't understand you. Presents and family. It's about drinking with a loved one. Merry Christmas, Leonard Skinner Jr. You too, bud. You too.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of.
That's a really sweet ending, huh? Even though the thing's still gonna kill the guy. I've seen this like, I don't know how many times, and each time I seem to forget the little subtitle thing. Anyway, this last one, sorry to say, I know this has been such an amazing episode, it must be painful for you for this to be the last one. And there's not gonna be an encore, so don't think about that. This last one was my favorite thing I've ever filmed, up until I made Deep in the Woods 3. See, you know, the Easter Bunny was even below it, in my opinion. Because Karma's a Bitch was just very well acted, it was a great story. And, yeah, take a look. Karma's a Bitch.
I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along. Yes, rolling along, and I'm quitting the blues of the world. I'm singing a song, yes, singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just told a parson, hey, Pa, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm going to fall, and I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along, rolling along. Don't want any million, I'm getting my share. I've only got one suit, just one, that's all I can wear. A bundle of money don't make me feel gay. a sweet little honey is making me sad. And I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along, rolling along. And I'm sweating.
Oh, shut up!
Please just let me go. What are you doing? What are you gonna do? Please! What are you gonna do? No, please!
Hold it, shut up.
Oh my God! Please, somebody help me! No. Please don't, please.
Oh, along. And I'm quitting the blues of the world. I'm singing a song. Singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just told the parson.
Oh. What is it? If you want them church people, just get your ass on down the road.
Actually, no. I'm streaming down the street. My car broke down on the way from WonderCon.
Yeah, what do you want me to do about it?
Well, I was wondering if I can come in and use your phone.
Yeah, come on in.
Thanks, I assure you I'll be out in a jiffy.
Hey, you can use this phone.
Oh, thanks much. I'll go call AAA.
Want something to drink?
Yeah, do you have any water? Bottled water, preferably?
Sure.
Thanks much.
Taking candy from a baby. Two in 1 week. It's never happened before.
Sir, your phone.
Here, I got that water for you.
Oh, thanks much. You sure have a phone to sit with me for 30 minutes.
What's the problem?
This water has been opened. I specifically asked for a bottle of water because
don't worry, I didn't piss in it.
I didn't think you did. It's just I have a phobia of these things.
Good, there's nothing wrong with it. Go ahead, drink it.
No, I'm sure there's nothing. I'm weird that way. Well, I'll go wait my car.
Well, you can stay here, sit on the couch and wait.
I'm going to be speaking to you. I'll show you.
Good.
You
got to
get back to your book. I know how.
Well, that book sucks. Go ahead, sit down.
What?
It's raining outside.
If you really don't mind, my car doesn't have any AC. Wow.
Let me see.
Thanks.
Sure you don't have the water?
night, friend.
What the hell's going on?
I could be asking you the same thing.
What do you mean?
I saw what you put in the water, hence me doing the old switcheroo. And then I found the knife in your back pocket. And to top it all off, I found the dead chick in your garage and I was looking for the tape. By the way, you need to buy some tape. I had to tie you up with an extension cord and that just doesn't really work.
Why the hell are you doing this?
Why are you asking me? You know you do it. But to answer your question, I feel like I have power when I do it. Like I'm doing something that's changing the world. And plus a guy like me doesn't have much to do on a Friday night, so... It's fun.
You're fucking crazy.
Who are you to judge me? You do the same thing, except I have more class. I make the person believe that I'm harmless. I make them trust me. You know? Much different. I'm not crazy. It's an art when I do it.
I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Actually, quite the contrary. I'm gonna kill you. Because you see, I fit every house on the left of this block, and I'm not going to let you killing me tarnish that record.
Fit every house on this block. I haven't seen no police, heard no police.
Well, that's because I've done it all tonight.
Yeah, right.
See, I know it's very hard to believe, but I'm not going to waste time arguing with you. Because, you see, it's getting very late, and I have to go to every other house on the block, and so I have to kill you. You're tied up, so it'll be pretty easy, actually. I went through your tools, and I found some good instruments. Something I can have fun with, you know? See, this knife could be fun.
What are you doing?
But this hammer would cause so much more pain. I'm just...
You want my tools.
Which one do you prefer, honestly? Which one would you prefer? Do you like that?
I'd kill you with both.
The slit across the throat?
And I'm gonna kill you with both as soon as I get out of these. The cord.
The only problem is you're not gonna get out of them, so... Which one do you prefer?
Do what you're gonna do. I'll see you in hell.
Yeah, the only difference is... You'll be seeing me a long time from now, because... I'm not gonna die. Hello there, ma'am. My car is broken down a few blocks back, and you're the first person to answer. Do you mind if I come in and get your phone?
Well, 3 out of 4 had surprise endings. That was pretty good. And, I just want to say, you know, thank you for watching and enjoying, over the past episodes, and, just want to let all the fans know, I appreciate it. This has been the Best of Horror Film Cinema. I'm James Briggs. And that's Bruce Campbell. I met him once. It was good. And he talked to me immediately. But anyway, the end? Maybe? I don't know. No, I'll make another Horror Film Cinema, don't worry. Good night, and good luck.